Crazy British weather today. It's windy, it's wet, and I'm doing a solar panel update for May. In this video, I'm going to take you through the Tesla Powerwall 2 and solar PV installation stats for May 2019. Phenomenal month, our best yet, 90% self-power. So let's get to it. Hi, John Tisbury here. If this is your first time here and you want to learn more about my solar installation and Tesla Powerwall, as well as cinematography and photography, start now by clicking the subscribe button and the notification bell icon down below. In this video, as I said in the intro, we're going to look at the stats for our PV installation for May 2019 and the Tesla Powerwall performance during that month. It was a phenomenal month. Again, we seem to be topping out each month from the previous month. Just to give you some context, if you haven't joined us before, where have you been? We based in the UK in the East Midlands. East Midlands, I think there. Was I in the West Midlands? No, definitely East Midlands. And we have a 4K installation that was done in 2011, September. And we had a Powerwall installed in December 2018. We've got a 3.8 kilowatt inverter, Sunny Boy inverter, and that's probably about it really. There's other bits which are tacked on to that, like the Zappy charger, and we're getting our Kona Electric in July. Our date's just been brought forward, just had an email about that. Very excited. I'll do another video on that. So without further ado, let's get into the stats. Again, those that tune in regularly know that I don't have the luxury of a web interface for my solar. So I'm the old-fashioned method of recording end of day and onto a spreadsheet. So that's what we're going to work our way through. And I've also linked down below in the description where the spreadsheet is, if that's of interest to you, because I know some of you like to do the same thing that I do, regardless to whether you have a Fandango web interface with all the stats on or not. Incidentally, as I'm going to do another video as well, because I was looking at the Tesla Powerwall app on one's phone, and I see that it's not actually that efficient, or accurate, probably is a better word, when you look at the self-power side of things, the percentage of self-power, it's out on a regular basis, at end of day, when it should be fixed as the final percentage. So I'll do another video on that, just picking out the inaccuracies in that. Up on screen is my spreadsheet. I've got May highlighted, and as I say, a phenomenal month. We had lots of days where we were 100% self-power by solar into the Powerwall. I don't take any additional power from the grid to charge the Powerwall. Purely at the moment, it is all straight from the solar. So if we have a poor solar day, we have a poor charge rate on the Powerwall. We'll be changing that later on, but not for this video to explain the reasons why and wherefore on that. So let's have a look. In terms of 100% power for the Powerwall over the month of May, we had, basically most of the days we managed to achieve 100% self-power. The only poor day was on the 8th of May. And we only did 31% self-power on that day. A dismal 6 kilowatt hours of solar generation, so it must have been a great day. And I've also been recording the start of the solar day and the end of the solar day in terms of the times, and we're running round about sort of 6 a.m. in the morning we start solar generation, and we end up around about 8 o'clock, just after 8 o'clock, so a good number of hours there, and we're coming to the longest day, daylight day in June, and I suspect it'll probably be similar around that sort of time frame. Let's bring up the monthly PV generation and daily average for each month. That's been incrementally climbing over the months from December last year through to May 2019. So in May, we did a total of 533 kilowatt hours during the month and a daily average of 17.2 kilowatt hours. Comparing that against last month, the total was 485 for April as opposed to 533. And the daily average has gone up as well from 16.2 to 17.2. So a nice increase there. Working down to the next, just gone a bit too far. There we go. This is the percentage contribution of the Powerwall 2 to solar to us total self-power. As I said in the intro, we did 90% self-power in May, and the contribution between the two, or the ratio between the two, is 52% of that self-power was from solar and 38% was from the Powerwall. So the Powerwall has been creeping up in its contribution to our self-power as we get more sunlight. Obviously the ratio there is fairly self-explanatory. If you look at the previous month, we were on 79% total self-power. So we've pushed up over 10% in May, which is excellent to see. More solar, which meant a little bit more use of the Powerwall in terms of percentage. So yeah, really pleased with that. That's awesome. Great figures to see, 90% self-power. So what that means is, in terms of what we've used from the grid, this is this chart here. So this is our monthly average home use from the grid in kilowatt hours. In May, we pulled from the grid on average 3 kilowatts a day, and the average home usage was 14. So we managed to basically, as I say, be self-sufficient for 90% of our needs. And as you'll see there on that particular chart, that's been tracking down over the months since December, when it was very close together, those two lines, what we actually used versus what we pulled from the grid, and they have been separating away over the months. This particular chart's a new one. I don't think I've used this before on the videos. This is what we actually sent to the grid. I thought it'd be useful to keep a track of that. Especially as we're now starting to look at how we're going to configure the charging for the Kona Electric into the mix. So in May, big old month of sending stuff away, 154 kilowatt hours we sent to the grid, compared to April, where we did 33. So I want to try and claw some of that back with the Zappy charger and taking the benefit from that. What else have I done? Oh yeah, another chart as well. God, it's all new, isn't it? This one here is tracking the percentage efficiency of the Tesla Powerwall in terms of what went in and what came out. So how much electricity did we put in and how much do we actually get out? And we're running around, let's have a look at the average there. Some average. 87%, so 87% efficiency in terms of what we put in, we get 87% of it out, which I think is fairly standard in terms of performance. I'm talking and looking at other people's stats on that. So we'll keep an eye on that, and I'm guessing that'll be a nice long-term track of the efficiency of the Powerwall over the coming years. We just had a generation payment as well from our energy supplier. Ours is really good, actually. We use EDF, and I sent them a meter reading on the 1st of June, and 2 days later they paid the amount, and we had £797.38, which is one of our bigger payments for the year. So, which is nice, and we benefit from being on the 52 pence kilowatt hour tariff because we were early adopters. So, that's handy. I think that's it really. That's all I wanted to cover. They're the key points. So hopefully you found that useful. Any questions, drop them down below and I'll do my best to answer them. And I shall see you on the next one. All right, take care. Bye.